Man. Boy, y'all know what LDBC? It's kind of crazy, man. It's really crazy that people complain about Deontay Wilder so much. So Deontay Wilder decides to not say anything at the press conference. Now, I'm not going to say these guys. I'm just going to say these races. Yeah, let's just come out and say races. You know, racist people say Deontay Wilder race baits too much. Okay. You know, all he do is race bait. All he do is this. Okay. Deontay Wilder didn't say anything. Now y'all complaining that he quiet? How? Why? I mean, you know, you racist said that, you know, he race baits and, you know, he tries to blame everything on race and he's a victim and all this stuff. Well, the man ain't said nothing. Okay? He ain't said two words. He pretty much kept his mouth shut. That's what Deontay Wilder did. And now, you racists are complaining that Deontay Wilder isn't helping selling the fight by not saying anything. Well, you know, I find this kind of comical because from what I heard and from what Bob Arum said, the pre-fight sales are pretty much, what, about $16 million? Now, this is what I heard. And I may be off by a couple of zeros or two or maybe a few digits, but the pre-fight sales for this fight are doing quite well. So that means the fights are already sold. Ah, you got to come up with another excuse. Man, what's the excuse now? So the fight's already sold. The fight's going to do well, of course. And if the pre-fight sales are, if they are as much as Bob Arum says they are, that means this fight is going to be huge. And that means that the pay-per-view sales are going to be through the roof, too. So what now? Oh, y'all said, well, Deontay Wilder didn't say anything because he's a coward. He's afraid. Deontay Wilder all of a sudden got mental issues. Now, that's the funniest thing I heard. So because the man is quiet, he got mental issues. Like, you know, some of you people, I'm sorry, racist, y'all are stupid. Like, y'all are dumb. Like, I mean, when George Floyd got killed, and it's crazy how you racists were saying, oh, man, I thought Deontay Wilder was for the people. I thought he was for the people. I thought he was for black people. Well, how come he hadn't said anything about George Floyd? Well, the minute he says something about George Floyd, he does a poem, a great poem. Oh, man, Wilder's just doing this for clout. You know, he's just being a diva. He's just being a media whore. Like, come on, man. Come on. So this dude, he can't win for losing. Like seriously. This is what people were saying. Sorry, not people, racist. This is what they were saying. I mean, just crazy. This is what they were saying. The man ain't make a statement about George Floyd for during the 2 weeks after it happened. And they say, oh, see, Deontay Wilder don't care about the people. He don't care about the people. Deontay Wilder just all talk. And then he says something. Oh, Deontay Wilder just trying to get some notoriety. Trying to gain clout off of George Floyd's death. That's despicable. I mean, come on, y'all. Crazy. Now Deontay Wilder is mentally weak. Because he ain't saying nothing. I'm going to tell you, the people who roll with Deontay Wilder, y'all know what I saw? I saw somebody who got revenge on his mind. That's the vibe I got. I didn't get a cowardly vibe. But, you know, it's the media and it's these racist fans that always try to paint this narrative that the black man is a coward. That's the narrative that you guys try to paint. And Deontay Wilder isn't afraid of Tyson Fury. See, here's the thing. How is somebody going to go through arbitration? How is somebody going to make all this noise about getting his rematch, right? And then y'all say he afraid. I mean, how does that make sense? How was he afraid of Tyson Fury when he was the one that wanted the Fury fight? Tyson Fury was the one that tried to fight AJ, but Deontay Wilder is afraid. Like, guys, you can't make this stuff up. Just admit that you guys are racist and you don't like the man because he's black. And then all you racist apologists, all you people that, you know, every chance you get, oh, man, Deontay Wilder's got a mental issue. Deontay Wilder this, Deontay. How does this constitute a mental issue? I don't get it. Wait a minute, isn't Tyson Fury the one that tried to commit suicide? But Deontay Wilder is the one that's mentally weak? Like, folks, is anybody listening to what I'm saying? Can you guys hear what I'm saying? Deontay Wilder ain't trying to take his own life. Deontay Wilder ain't been on no cocaine bench. He's the one that's mentally weak. Like, come on, people. Are you serious? Man, Deontay Wilder ain't seeing no psychologist for mental health, and I don't make fun of people who have to do that. Okay, because mental health is serious. It's real serious. So I don't make fun of that. But Deontay Wilder ain't going to see no specialist, man. How is he mentally weak? The man that's mentally weak is right here. The man that's about 20, 40 pounds overweight is right here. Look, he's right here. This is the mentally weak guy right here. This guy. Man, I can't with some of you racists. I just can't. That's why I don't even give you dudes a chance. I don't give y'all a chance. I don't give y'all nothing. Y'all don't get an inch on this channel. Y'all don't get an inch because you guys attack those soliloquies and I just look at them and go, delete. Because I'm not listening to it. I'm not listening to your feelings or what you think or your opinion. I don't care about your opinion. Your opinion don't matter to me. This man is not weak, man. Deontay Wilder got revenge on his mind. This is what I see. I see vengeance. I see a man that's fed up, and I see a man that's on a mission. I see a man that want to fight and knock this guy head off. That's what I see. I don't know what everybody else seeing. I don't know this cowardly person that y'all see. Deontay Wilder going to get this. He going to get that. Oh, okay. Well, here's what it is. It is what it is. I mean, you have to see when the fight happened. But I'm not calling either one of these two. I don't think either one of these two are afraid to fight the other ones. I don't think they're afraid. I just think they got to do what they got to do. But Wilder didn't try to avoid this fight, though. Tyson Fury tried to avoid this fight, this third fight. But we're calling Wilder the coward. Like, oh, man, this is crazy. Deontay Wilder can't catch a break. He's never going to be able to catch a break. Like, it's just, you know, he say high, everybody else say low. Man, Deontay Wilder, man, he's a straight sucker for that glove gate. Blah, 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 blah. Let it have been Deontay Wilder, you know, having his glove halfway off his hand. Man, them racers would have been in full force trying to get Deontay Wilder banned from boxing. They'd have tried to get him banned from boxing. See, I know this, man. And I'm going to tell you, too, what Deontay Wilder did that was so funny. I'm going to tell you what he did, man, that was just crazy. Deontay Wilder, not only did he not talk to, he ain't talked to the media, man. And the media, they got that old media, they got mad. Old media was pissed. But, you know, I don't blame Deontay Wilder. Why in the hell would I give old media an interview, right? Why would I give these people an interview when they try to act like they for me when they see me? And then they turn right behind my back, and when anything go down, they put a bunch of articles, negative articles and negative press about me. They say things about me that's not true. Why? Why should Deontay Wilder give these guys these interviews? And it's funny, Deontay Wilder stirred it up. He did an interview with Fred from Barbershop Conversations, man. He did an interview with 78 Sports TV. They shut old media out, man. I found it funny. And I'm laughing. I'm still laughing right now that they shut old media out. They shut them out. I mean, why? Why? Why keep giving these guys any press? Y'all know what old media got to do? Old media got to come to the LDBC or, you know, they got to come to Barbershop Conversation or they got to come to Blue Blood Sports to get the story. And I think Deontay Wilder, he'll talk to Ellie Sattback. He'll talk to him. I don't remember seeing, you know, Ellie Sattback saying a lot of crazy stuff about Wilder. Okay, now y'all correct me in the comment section if I'm wrong, because I think Ellie Sattback was probably one of the other normal media people. And when I say normal media, you know, it's not, you know, anybody, you know, like non-black media that didn't tear Deontay Wilder up with Glovegate. From what I know. But let me know, because if Ellie Sattback did, I'm going to roast him. Okay? I think Ellie Sattback interviewed people. Now, he interviewed people who, you know, they gave their opinion on Glovegate. But Ellie Sattback himself didn't give an opinion. So I think Deontay Wilder, you know, is okay with Ellie Sattback. Man, but he shut the rest of them out. He shut them dudes out, man. Don't want to talk to him. Don't want to talk to him. And I don't blame him. I'm not going to give an interview to somebody, man, who's going to write a negative article about me that's not even true. Well, a lot of times, these folks that got Deontay Wilder number, they can call him and just ask him what the deal is, but they don't do that either. They just go ahead and write the press about Deontay Wilder, because when you take a dump on Deontay Wilder, that's always a good thing. You can take a dump on him. So, yeah, he shut him out. The man put the, when they were trying to ask him a question, the man put the headphones on. Had the headphones on and ignored them guys. And Malik Scott answered all the questions. He don't want to talk to them. Wasn't because he was afraid or he was shaking, he was mentally weak. He don't want, he tired of the BS. I mean, anybody with a brain can see Deontay Wilder tired of the BS from these people, man. Don't blame him, man. Shut everybody out, man. People who got your back, man, you deal with the people that got your back. You deal with the people that got your back, and you don't deal, oh man, look at this. Somebody asking to join the Facebook group. And you don't deal with the people, you know, who don't have your back. It's just as simple as that. Deontay Wilder has chosen to shut old media out. Okay? All the racists and bigots, he's shutting these people out. Then people starting to get on him about JD's. I don't know why JD still got a job. And y'all know good and well if Deontay Wilder would have fired JD's, then you know what the racists would have said, or you know what the old media would have said, you know what the people that hate Wilder would have said? Well, he only fired JD's because he's white. It was a no-win situation. Then Deontay Wilder got rid of Mark Breland. Now everybody up in the air about Mark Breland. See, man, see, Deontay Wilder's supposed to be a real man, man. He ain't no brother, man. Look at, he fired the black guy. And now all of you people, y'all care about Mark Breland. When you were the guy suggesting, oh, sorry, not guys, racist. When you were the racist suggesting that Deontay Wilder get rid of Mark Breland, because Mark Breland wasn't good, you know, he wasn't a good trainer. I mean, that's what y'all was saying. Okay, got rid of Mark Breland. Y'all hated that. Now, he brought in Malik Scott. Oh, man, this is laughable. Malik Scott knocked Deontay Wilder out. How is he his trainer? Look, Freddie Roach got his ass whooped many times. He's a trainer. I don't even think Nazim Richardson, the great Nazim Richardson, boxed a fight in his life. He was a great trainer. Roger Mayweather, he was a decent fighter. He wasn't like the best fighter. He was a great trainer. Floyd Mayweather Sr., he was a good trainer. Still is. I mean, come on, man. Come on. Some of the best trainers in the world never fought before. Never fought. Or wasn't that great at fighting. They wasn't great fighters. They're trainers now. Because it's almost like that scenario, like your mind, there's some great minds in boxing. But their body, they don't have the physicality to execute what their mind wanted them to do. They never were great athletes. They're boxing minds, but they were never great athletes. So therefore, you know, they're trainers. Like Nate Jones, he was a decent boxer, but he wasn't a gifted athlete like Floyd Mayweather. But Nate Jones is a boxing mind. He knows boxing. He understands boxing. So, I mean, you know, all you got to do is understand the concept and you can be a good trainer. So let's really get off of Malik Scott. I mean, Malik Scott, I'll tell you what. Let's say if Deontay Wilder go in here and knock Fury Smoove out. Let's just say if it happened. I mean, I don't know. Is Malik Scott going to get any credit? Is he going to get any credit? It's crazy. And I remember, you know, man, oh, man, you know, we don't like Floyd Mayweather because he's boring. He don't get knockouts. Well, Deontay Wilder getting knockouts. Oh, we don't like Deontay Wilder because he's race-based. Okay, well, he ain't saying that now. He ain't saying nothing. Now what? Oh, man, you know, he's a coward. Why? Because he ain't talking? It's just a no-win situation. No-win situation. Well, the fight's sold, people. The fight is sold. So try again. The fight is sold. The fight is sold itself. Okay, the first two fights sold the third fight. Deontay Wilder, what else does he need to say? He don't need to say nothing else. He needs not say nothing else. All he need to do is get ready to go perform. That's it. I see somebody with revenge on his mind.